Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be answering a question that was asked on the SketchUp subreddit by TerexMD, who asks, how do I distort this building face to fit into this smaller box with a distorted look, making the lower levels smaller than the much larger upper levels? Frito Scale doesn't do this. We're going to be jumping into that after the intro. Alright, so I've opened up SketchUp and I've made a simulation of the facade that Terex is talking about. So this is basically a bunch of lines. And what I would do to do this is that there's basically no scale feature in SketchUp that allows you to skew or distort the facade. I looked at a bunch of plugins. Natively, I don't think there's anything. There may be a plugin somewhere, somehow, but I wasn't able to find one. The way that I would go about doing this is actually all available, or you're able to do it just in the SketchUp itself without any plugins. So what I would do is I would turn this into a texture so that I don't have to worry about all the lines. And the way that I would do that is you want to make sure you go to camera, go parallel projection, and make sure you have that checked, and then standard views, and then you want to find the right view. So I'm going to select front here. That looks like it's the right view. It's flat on. And then you want to go to your styles and whatever style you want. You may want to make a new one if this is the style that you want to keep. You want to come over here to this blue. You want to turn off the model axes. And then under background settings, you want to turn off sky and then change the background. You may want to change this. You may not. We're going to keep it. Because we're just going to make a PNG anyway. So go to File, Export, 2D Graphic, and then go to Options. Make sure that you have Transparent Background selected. That'll make sure that the background that you have is transparent. I'm going to call this Facade, and then I will save it. Now I've opened up Photoshop here to make some edits to the texture that we just created, or the, I guess it's an image at this point, but you can use any photo editing software that can crop, because that's essentially all we're going to do in here. But since I have Photoshop, I like to use it when I can. So I'm going to just find that file and open it. Facade. Okay. So that'll import it. And you can see that there's a bunch of this extra space. So we just want to get rid of that. So I'm just going to use the crop tool. And it actually snaps because that's the only like physical object. Digital object. I'm going to save that, close out of Photoshop, go back to the SketchUp, and I'm just going to make a copy of this. So this is where we started. We're going to come here, and then I'm going to delete some of these lines. I'm just using the eraser tool. Actually, you know what? It might be just quicker if I make this a group. Just make this a rectangle over top of that. Just copy this group off to the side since that's what it looks like. And then I'm just going to go to perspective again just because that's a little bit easier. So the next thing I want to do is in my default tray, I want to find the materials bar, make a new material, go to use texture image, and then find that facade texture, open that. Now I can hit OK and it'll make a new texture. You can rename it if you want. So we'll just call this facade. I'm going to hit B here, and that's going to bring up the paint bucket tool, and you're going to see I'm going to paste it, but it's super, super tiny. So what I want to do is measure this. So let's say 15'9¾". So in this, go to the edit and then change this to, what was that again? Sorry, 15'9¾". So 15'9.75", and then if I just come up to facade, you can see it'll change that automatically, and now they look very similar. So we have that. I'm just going to copy this off to the side. We'll make a few adjustments to where these points are located. So we'll change this one as well. And then you want to just right click on the face. You don't want to have all of these things selected, just the face itself. And that'll give you an option for texture. So left click on the face, right click, texture, position. Now that'll give you these four little pins. The first one that you want to place is this right, so I'm just holding this down, and you can see it'll snap to that corner. And you want to go bottom left, bottom right, top left, top right. So we're going to place this one, and we're just going to hold it down until we get to that point there. Same thing with this top one. Okay, then when you're finished this, you just right click, hit done. Now you can see that I have this weird shape. It kind of looks like it's in perspective, but it's actually flat. So that may be something that you want. I assume that's what this, what Terex is looking for. That's what we have here. Now you could, if you wanted lines again, you could come in and draw over these lines. You may be okay with just this texture itself. Alternatively, this one is if you essentially want to keep this. So let's say we want to do the same thing, but we want to do it with lines. So I'm just going to actually turn this to red, just so that we can see it a little bit differently. And what I would do is just take this top portion. So essentially make four copies of this. The top and the bottom are the same in this. You could scale it differently if you want, or you could position it differently, I guess is what I mean. So I'm just going to try to get this corner to be... I'm just going to use the arrow keys to lock to the axes, and then we'll just get it there slowly but surely. So then rotate this. Now I need to scale it. So we are going to, we can probably just use this. Yeah, that's quick, nice and quick. So we can do that with this one. Do something similar with this guy. S for scale, just scale this. And then with this, we want to do, essentially what we're doing is we're making reference points that has scaled each of these to the correct location. So we have this guy, and then we're going to copy that. And this is like the manual way of doing it. And scale this up. Okay, so then you just connect your points. So we have this here. And then we're just going to speed this up, and we'll come back after we're finished so you can see what it looks like and compare it to the other one that we did. All right, so there we go. We have our two physical objects here. I'm just going to put this side by side. Just so you can see what they look like. Obviously, very similar, just constructed a little bit differently. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.